I want all of you to know I'm better than you.
Before this video begins, I just want to remind everyone that the podcast, the video version, is no longer being posted on this channel. So if you've been wondering, hey, how come I'm not seeing new episodes here? That's because it's not being uploaded here. It's now on the official podcast YouTube channel, Typical. If you're someone who has been watching the podcast on this channel, please go subscribe to the new Typical YouTube channel that's dedicated to the podcast and enjoy it from there. With all that said, let's get into the video. After canceling the Olympics because of people getting sick a year ago, this year they said, not again. And now the 2021 Olympic Games have arrived. I don't know anything about the Olympics. I really don't. I just know the basics. It happens every 4 years. There's a winter version. The top of the top athletes from almost every country train their entire lives to compete in their respective events. These people are Olympians, which is not a title applicable. Just throw the video away. People are Olympians, which is not a title applicable for 95% of the world population. They are human beings at their physical peak pretty much all the time. So I'm making this video to educate myself on the Olympic Games. So I pulled up a list of the events on my phone from their official website, and we'll go through some. Archery. Everyone loves a good archer. Archery is impressive. I really do think archery is impressive. I think archery is really cool. And with the help of shows and movies, they've made archery seem like it is way easier than it actually is. But how come they have archery? Do you think, why not like slingshots? I'm just getting in the mindset. Why not slingshots? You know, if we're at archery, why not slingshots? Why not catapults? Just saying. You get like a big cornhole game, you know, where they have like the bag and like you toss it. Instead of like a bag, it's a boulder and it's a catapult, you know, one catapult one end, one catapult the other end. Got like this giant bucket or a pond, perhaps. If we're gonna go medieval, why not step up a level? Artistic gymnastics. I was actually supposed to be in there. Yeah, I was destined. 5-year-old me, I was rolling around. I did rolls. I rolled forward and backwards. Forward and backwards. But my 5-year-old mind told me, I don't want to train my whole life to do this, to just be a professional roller. That's why I didn't really go for it, because my 5-year-old self made the decision for me. And, you know, now we'll never know. We'll never know what could have been. And on the same subject of artistic gymnastics, we got artistic swimming. You know, I was supposed to be in... Okay. Okay. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm looking at the list on the website, and they're all pretty specific. You know, you got 3x3, basketball, archery, gymnastics, badminton, baseball, softball. And then you got pretty early on, above, like near the top of the list, you just have athletics. Hey, you watching the Olympics? I'm watching athletics, yeah. What are you watching? What's your favorite event? You know me. I like football. Football's a good one. Or basketball. Basketball's fun. What about you? Athletics. Which one? All of them. Athletics. Like, the only other way I could think of this is if you're at a stadium and someone's like, oh, hey, what are you here to watch? Sports? You're here to watch... Yeah. Oh, yeah, we have that. But like, specifically, which one? Sports. I just find it funny how they just simply have athletics. But apparently athletics is actually like all the running shit. Badminton. Badminton's fun. I don't know. I got a little excited. I saw it on the list. I got a little excited about it. I think it's just a fun one. I literally couldn't think of a joke for badminton. I think it's a better tennis. BMX freestyle. That's dope. I rode a bike. On the list they have boxing, and I don't know, that one seems more Olympic game-like. I don't know what it is, but in my mind, when I think of like history lessons and whatever, when I think of the Olympics, I think of like physical altercations game. One nation, another nation, just one person duking it out, you know, just like, boom! Almost gladiator-like. That's my impression of the Olympics. So it's kind of surprising me seeing that they have like, you know, canoe and kayaking. I was expecting more like 1v1 type of stuff, but it's, you know, it's okay. You know, they modernized it. I guess they're cutting back on people dying or getting seriously injured. They saw the future and they're like, we don't want to get canceled for violence, so we're gonna dial it back. I quickly skipped past canoes and kayaks because I don't understand them. I'm just assuming that it's some sort of race, but inside a not as fun boat. Diving. That's a weird one for me. Like, I have always oddly respected it a lot for some reason. Not sure why. Maybe it's because I don't really know how to dive. Like, I've just kind of dove into water. And maybe I'm good, maybe I'm not. They're really high up. They jump, they do all these twirls, flips, whatever. And then they just, at the very end, they just bloop in a straight line. And that's impressive to me. I'm like, well, I know I can't do that. But kayaking and canoeing, I'm like, put me in that. Put me in that vehicle. And I can guarantee I'm not going to sink. I'm just going to keep coming back. Every chance I get, I'm just going to come back and keep shitting on canoeing and kayaking. Wait, what's happening? I witnessed myself in so many different alternate realities, and there were many different versions of myself. It wasn't just one that won every single event. It was multiples of me winning singular events. So I watched them all though. I've witnessed winning and getting gold in every single Olympic game event category. Every single one I won. And holy fucking shit, I won one for canoeing and kayaking. Equestrian. That's, I don't know if I said that right, but it's horses. It's horse stuff. So that way your mind doesn't wander. When I say horse stuff, it's horse racing. Don't want you thinking horse sperm, like most of you probably went to. Dirty thinkers. Dirty. You guys got dirty minds. I was talking about horse racing and, you know, horse activities like that. I can't ride a horse. All these events, I'm just going down the list. I'm like, well, I can't do this one. That's why it's in the Olympics. Fencing. Fencing's cool. I'm laughing. I'm sorry. Fencing's cool because that's like swords, you know? But it's also kind of lame because the swords are flimsy. A long sewing needle. So the thing that makes it cool is also kind of makes it lame. Oh, real quick, I actually learned something. The athletics category, you know, the athletics, the running ones, those ones were actually, I think, some of the oldest Olympic game events. I learned that. They're a lot older than a lot of these. That's me putting some respect on athletics. What's handball? I don't know what handball is. If it's like spike ball, I think I'd love to watch this. Oh, here we go. On the list, we have some more fighting ones. We got judo. I don't know much about judo. I really don't. You know, I don't know much about any of these events. Marathon swimming. You know, human beings are not meant to be fish. I'm just saying. I'm not saying anything bad. I'm just saying that we are able to swim. Maybe not for a marathon, but we can swim. We're capable. I'm just saying. They have rowing, and I thought canoes and kayaks were going to be the lamest thing on the list, or the thing that I would dislike the most, but they have rowing. They have rowing. I'm trying to visualize it. The way I see it is just a bunch of people stacked into one boat, just a really long canoe. That's how I visualize rowing. I've never seen rowing before, ever, but that is how I see it. I also believe for the first time ever, they added skateboarding as like an official Olympic game event. I mean, it makes sense, you know, it takes a while, but it is a shame that it's taken this long to actually add it. You know, I used to really be into riding a ripstick. Like, it used to be my thing. And I kind of stopped because my heart just like fell out of it. But if I knew I could have been an Olympic gold medalist if I just kept riding, maybe I would have stuck with it. Maybe they changed my future by not having this sooner. I mean, I didn't have to show you, but I did. See, I come with receipts. I'm serious. I know how to ride a ripstick. That's not necessarily skateboarding, but judges, their heads would be turned. The last event I'll quickly go over feels like the most Olympic game event there is, and that's wrestling. That's gotta be the most Olympic thing, especially in the terms of history for the Olympics. You know, that's gotta be a major, it's gotta be a major player. Because, you know, back then, they didn't have fucking canoes. Because, you know, back then, they didn't have canoes and kayaks. So they wouldn't have existed as events. And some would say, rightfully so. I hope a lot of you actually did take some value out of this video. Because I actually did. I had zero knowledge on the Olympics. And now, I have a smaller amount of knowledge on it. But still an increase. Still a positive. So yeah, thank you guys for watching this video. And I'll be in the Olympics next time. I won the canoeing and kayaking. That's why I don't see this in my future. I don't want that to be a reality. I'm doing everything in my power to not do that. I've never been on a canoe or a kayak. But what if that is my future? Being a gold medalist for that. I'm not even trying. But what if I don't have a say in what I do in my life? What if I'm not controlled? What if none of us are controlling our lives and we're just going on this path? What if when I'm 30, I win gold medal as a canoe. As a canoe. Not even just rowing a canoe, just as a canoe. I become one. Fuck. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm done.